The story is about Susanna Cahalan, who ends up with a disease called anti-NMDA autoimmune encephalitis, and it's treatable. And it had only been discovered a couple of years before that, but nobody really knew about it. And she was lucky enough to be a reporter and to be cured and to write about it. And so it's important because it's going to bring awareness to this this disease. It certainly has, the book certainly brought awareness to the neurological community across the world, so they started looking for it. And, you know, we think sadly of the thousands, probably tens or hundreds of thousands of people who were misdiagnosed and didn't end up getting treated and ended up in a catatonic state or dead or on the street or in a psych ward. And so I think that's why it's important. It's also the story of family sticking together and of perseverance and of, you know, really following your conviction. And the character played by Carrie Ann Moss of Susanna's mother, she was the one who really kept on pushing and said, no, our daughter's in there and she doesn't have schizophrenia and you've got to find out what's wrong with her. And eventually they did, which is great.
Susanna's played in this film by one of our glittering young stars in Chloe Grace Moretz. Can you talk a little bit about what makes her such a unique talent and what we can expect from her performance in this specific film?
Well, she is fearless and she just dives in, and it was wonderful working across from her because I never knew what she was going to do next, and so I had to be really on my toes and just rolling with what she was doing. And I think it's one of those parts that we dream as actors to play a really challenging part like this. And I think she's just done an incredible job. Yeah.
And can you tell us just a little bit about your character, Dr. Ryan, and where he fits into Susanna's journey?
Yeah. Well, Dr. Ryan is one of the first people who sees her in the psych ward and tries to diagnose what's wrong with her, and he can't. And he works very hard to try to figure out what it is. But like literally, maybe five people knew about what this disease was. And so I think, in the big scope of things, what he represents is the 99.99% of doctors out there who had no idea what this was, and it's an important sort of force of an obstacle that everybody is pushing against. And you know, he wasn't a bad guy. He wasn't dumb. They just, nobody really knew about this disease.
I guess, how important do you feel films like this are in destigmatizing mental illness and its treatment?
Yeah, that's a really, really great question, and I really think it's important. You know, we unfortunately as a society like to make fun of people who have mental illness. We tend to walk, you know, the other way when we see them on the street, and we don't do that when people maybe have, you know, a liver disease or, you know, cancer. We tend to give them more care. Somehow there's a stigma with the brain and it scares us more. And I think that hopefully what this will do is allow people to have a little bit more compassion, a little bit more empathy, a little bit more tolerance, so that we can embrace people who are sick, whether the disease is in the mind or whether it's anywhere else in the body.
What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's TIFF?
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, I'm very proud Canadian, and TIFF is such a great festival, and everybody's been so warm, and it's so exciting. Toronto's just buzzing all week, and you get quite exhausted going to the parties and, you know, going to films. We've seen some great films, and it's just great to be here.